First of all, Gary, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
How are you feeling right now, sir? You all right?
Good.
We're in a warm hotel room in central London.
Yes.
It's not ideal, is it? Did you have any sort of reservations with doing the film? There's a lot of CGI work. It's a lot of talking to, you know, people that aren't really there effectively, but they are, and you're kind of doing it on location. Did you have any reservations about getting involved with the film?
Well, you sort of surrender to the process. I mean, if you're going to make a movie like this, you kind of... Well, I certainly know what to expect because I've been in a few of these big movies and you know, with the Harry Potter series and Batman. There's a bit of that, you know. There's a great deal of it. Some of it is there. Some of it isn't there at all. It's the first movie that I've seen where I was just completely awestruck by the finished product.
Yeah,
I mean, you're lucky in as much that you're working with Andy Serkis, so you're getting the intensity of the performance because you're not. It would be that much harder if you were working with him in a mask. But to then see the final thing put together, I was quite blown away by
the film itself is kind of all about trust and humanity, and I think there's a certain level of trust you have to instill in somebody like the director to deliver.
Completely.
You can only go so far when you're talking to someone who's not in costume. He's a CGI character, effectively.
Yeah.
And surely you have to give the director a heck of a lot of trust that you're not going to look foolish at the end of the day.
Yeah, and he in turn is then, you know, talking to the Weather, who did all the digital rendering.
Yeah.
Flying, just, you know, I mean, it's just on instruments, you know. He doesn't know where the horizon is. He doesn't know if he's upside down. I mean, and they're all saying,
yeah,
it'll be terrific. It'll be, I mean, the new thing that they did with this, which I think sort of sets it apart and has raised the bar, is that they took 3D cameras onto location. They used natural light and one directional sort of source lighting.
Right.
They shot it with long lenses. So they shot it like 2D or like a regular movie.
Yeah.
That was a particular look that Matt was going for. He used a cinematographer called Michael Sarrazin, who is very sort of did all that work with Alan Parker. I mean, it's sort of a signature look that he can give you. So it's got a real. It's never really been done to that extent.
That
much on location. Yeah. And all the stuff that you saw, throughout the movie, but in the beginning of the movie, in the forest, is all done with natural light.
Yeah.
There's not one lamp.
Right, it's just completely...
They couldn't get them up there. They couldn't get them into the...
You just had to make do with what you...
And you're lucky, and you are working with a digital 3D camera.
Mm.
Obviously, it's not a film camera. So, you know, you've got a wider, you've got, you know, your stop is, you're not limited to the range of what, you know, unless you're using like fast film. But so it was a whole new thing. It was a new thing for Matt. And these guys were saying, look, you know, you direct the scene how you want to direct the scene and move the apes and as you would a normal movie.
And we'll just catch up.
And we will render it for you.
Funny for now, we're kind of running out of time, unfortunately.
Run out of time already.
Funny for now, I'm a massive fan of John Le Carré and George Smiley. Any news on the next film? Whether it's happening, whether it might not be happening?
I would hope it would happen, but I have not heard A Dickie Bird.
Oh, okay. Well,
but I'd like to play George again. Yeah. That's, you know, got to get Carla.
Yeah.
Got to get him.
Got to get him. Well, we've all read the books. We know what happens there. Yeah. Gary, thank you so much for speaking to us.
Yeah. Take it easy.